Hello everyone, this is Ninetales Commander and I welcome you to episode 28 of Pokemon Battle Arena. This is another friend match I had against my friend Dinomen 12, or rather Dinomen now I suppose, and he's going to lead off with his Jolteon and I'm going to lead off with my Meowstic. Immediately I already make a big mistake, completely forgetting that Jolteon has the ability to learn Signal Beam, but luckily I am able to survive it with only 2 HP. But unfortunately for me, this is already quite bad as I actually do carry the Life Orb, which means I'm going to get KO'd right away. But at least I was able to pull off a Psyshock just before I went down. So my next Pokemon in line is my shiny Whimsicott, which I still say looks really dang awesome. He switches out his Jolteon, obviously because any Electro-type move he has is not going to do too much damage to my Grass-type Whimsicott. He goes out into Beedrill, which is obviously his Mega Pokemon for this team, but I decide to take advantage of the switch and go straight in for a Leech Seed, which is already pretty good for me because that means I'm going to be recovering HP at the end of every turn. Not wanting to take a Bug-type attack straight to the face, I go out into my Seismitoad. I love Seismitoad. This Pokemon, it looks so cool. It looks so awesome and I really like it. Okay, so obviously he's going to use his Mega-Beedrill on the next turn. Why else would you use a Mega-Beedrill apart from trying to be different? So he goes for Drill Run. I'm really not that tough, I'm not too bothered about the Drill Run because my Seismitoad does have pretty good defenses. So I take that with pretty decent damage. I take it really well actually. So he draws out, he switches out. I was watching too much Yu-Gi-Oh that is. So he switches out into his Delmise and I go for the Rock Slide. I don't expect this to do too much damage. It is a non-stab move after all. And plus Delmise's defenses are actually pretty good. So obviously, yeah, that's not going to do too much damage. So I don't want to take a grass type attack directly. So I go back into my Whimsicott as I am a grass fairy type. And that means that he's going to go for Toxic, which I guess he predicted my switch because I was expecting a grass type move, but obviously he knew better. So he predicted that and went straight in for the Toxic. At least that's my assumption anyway. So obviously he's carrying the leftovers and as of now I've lost my Leech Seed support. Actually, did my Leech Seed support actually do anything? I don't think it did. Fortunately, I also carry Toxic, so I can also poison the opposing Delmise. So he's going to go ahead and use Gyro Ball, which is really bad for me because that's going to do a truckload of damage since I'm a Park Fairy type. I do carry the leftovers, which is pretty good, but yeah, that was still a really strong move. And honestly, I completely forgot that Delmise has the ability to use Steel type moves due to its ability. Delmise is like the only Pokemon in the game that has technically three stab moves, like three moves that get same type attack bonus. As far as I'm aware anyway, that's the way it goes. So that's actually pretty cool. I actually thought he might go for some sort of status move, but I did not think he was going to switch out to his Empoleon. But this actually still ended up being pretty good for me, as apparently this particular Empoleon is actually a bit of a team supporting Empoleon. So by using Taunt, I've actually got myself in a pretty good spot. Apart from the fact that Leech Seed went ahead and missed, which means I was unable to pull off the Leech Seed. That was really unlucky. I actually would have really could have done with that. So I bring in my Seismitoad now. You're probably wondering why am I bringing in a part ground type against a water type. Well, I actually carry the water absorb and that means I can absorb all of the water type attacks. He predicts my earthquake unfortunately and goes out into his Togekiss. But fortunately, I avoid the Air Slash, which means I basically get to do a Poison Jab for pretty much no cost, which is pretty dang awesome. And I'm even able to get off the Poison, which is pretty good. I actually do like that because it makes up for the Leech Seed missing. So he's going to go for Air Slash now, which is, yeah, it's not going to do much damage. But of course, the infamous Serene Grace with Air Slash with Togekiss. It's been around since pretty much Togekiss made its debut back in Generation 4. It's still pretty infamous in the metagame, and honestly, it's no wonder people use it. Even I use it, and I honestly don't blame people for using it because it is a really good strategy. So he brings in his Delmise, and I bring in my Heatran because, well, it just makes perfect sense. He's got a Delmise, I've got a Heatran. I might as well bring it in since I pretty much resist all of his moves thanks to being a Steel type. Well, except for his Ghost type moves, but I'm still pretty fine with that. So I go for the Fire Blast. This is going to do a good chunk of damage. It doesn't do a lot, though I do get the burn, which is actually pretty dang awesome for me. Though I am still behind, as I've got two Pokemon that are dead, well, fainted, and my opponent still has all six of his Pokemon, so I really need to get some KOs going here to have any chance of winning. So I bring in my Seismitoad now, predicting the water type attack, and I do get predict it correctly, and I do recover a bunch of HP thanks to the water absorb. Now, fortunately, I do have the burn damage also helping me out, which is actually really helpful since Empoleon can be quite a defensive Pokemon. I go for Ice Punch, completely predicting the switch to the Togekiss, and I was like, oh no, he actually predicted I would stay in. I would use the Ice Punch, and he actually stayed in and used his Empoleon. Now, this next turn is literally a repeat. I actually thought he was going to stay in this time, thinking I was going to go for another Ice Punch. I went for the Earthquake, but this time he predicted me correctly and goes out into his Togekiss. But I'm not too bothered about it, because I do have the Poison helping me out, which is pretty dang awesome. He goes for the Air Slash, which does a lot of damage, and of course that's going to make me flinch. But I'm not too bothered about it, because the Poison is going to finish off that Togekiss at the end of this turn. So he brings out Zynga, which of course is his Mega-Beedrill. This thing is actually a bit of a threat now to my Seismitoad, because now I've lost a lot of HP, which means Exeter is going to kill me. I did pretty much deliberately leave my Seismitoad in, as there wasn't really anything I could go out into, except maybe Heatran, but I didn't want to risk getting hit by a Drill Run. So he goes for Drill Run, and I was like, oh, I'm actually slower than he is. Now this is a part of the battle where I realized, oh no, the Pokemon preview screens don't tell you what your nature is. See, my Heatran actually has a Choice Scarf, and I was hoping that was going to make me outspeed him, but it looks like I'm running the Adamant nature, which means I'm still not fast enough, which means at this point, this Beedrill is effectively going to kill me. My only hope I have now is I do have Butterfree. I know that's quite a fitting ending. And I'm carrying a Focus Sash, and I have the Quiver Dance, which means hopefully if I survive this, I can do a Quiver Dance, but no, I get poisoned. I get poisoned, the Quiver Dance no longer matters, and that ultimately means I have lost. So that was really, I was really unlucky. Well, actually, I want to say I was unlucky, but I did get a few lucky breaks in that battle with things like the burn and the poison. But despite all of that, I still lost the match. I still have one more match against Kevin in the next video, so hope you guys look forward to that, and this is me signing off, and I'll catch you guys next time. Peace.